This is part 19 of Breath of the Wild. In this part, we're going to take on a Bokoblin camp again. We're going to mark some shrines that we see, and we're going to make our way to a shrine that's actually out on the Floret Sandbar. But we're not going to quite get into that shrine because somebody has a little bit of difficulty getting to it.
And I got to admit, like, I haven't seen the rest of this entire Let's Play series, but I don't know how a video part is going to beat this one because...
Oh, it's bad.
This ending, like, you get into this Floret Sandbar is just terrible. It's god-awful. And, like, yeah, I was going to dog on you a little bit for your gameplay, as you did for me. But,
hey,
like, this might be one of the worst... like recordings, like trying to get a task done that we've had since we started Two Guys Playing Zelda.
This is up there with me jumping into the lava when I panicked in the Goron Mines back in Twilight Princess. This is a rough one, and like we've kind of talked about, we'll as a Let's Play, we're going to laugh at the mistakes we
Definitely.
Make. We're going to laugh at the times we die a stupid death or have a really horrible fight or a bad throw or a bad jump. You know, that's part of doing a Let's Play. Is it's not going to be perfect, but...
We do those in our walkthrough also.
when we actually know
what
true.
We're doing, we still make mistakes, and we just, you know, every once in a while, you gotta have some fun in your life. You got a dog on your boy who just made a stupid mistake, and then sadly, like it's either one of us are one or the other are recording. So at least now it's not me recording. I kind of get to get back at you a little bit, like you know what you did to me for so long.
Hey, I don't blame you, and all I can do is laugh along with you because you'll see it here at the end of this part.
Yeah.
First, we're going to take out another Bokoblin camp, though, and this is one, and there are a lot of them actually throughout the game that have like these metal boxes or crates, whatever you want to call them, around the camp. And I'm a big fan of the ability to use Magnesis in these metal crates to take out enemies because the big thing is it saves wear and tear on your own weapons.
Definitely.
And it also kind of like, it helps you keep the enemies a little bit further away, but I'm just not very good at it, as you're seeing
well,
here.
I mean, it's very difficult. I thought Magnesis as a rune was like really difficult to use. Probably one of the most difficult. This is, what's it called? The stasis where it can stop time. Actually hitting like the object a certain way, that was a little bit difficult. But
that could be,
moving that Magnesis up and down, left and right, it was a little bit difficult. Now, one thing I have an issue is, and I think I honestly was not paying attention to the screen, but I think you already hit that one Bokoblin and like he goes flying. There's
he
no
does.
Way you barely moving that metal block caused that Bokoblin to go flying that far across the screen.
I will say, though, that is another thing I like about the Magnesis is it does, like, it sends them flying. It does a lot of damage to these low-level enemies. Now, a little later in the game, as the enemies become more and more powerful, it does less and less damage,
definitely.
Which, you know, makes sense. But I love sending them flying with that Magnesis early on, even though you'll see as we progress that even when I'm taking on camps that have the metal blocks, I really don't use it a whole lot. Part of it is, like you said, it's just, it's not simple to do. And to me, it's just like, it's fun to try it and try out the mechanic. And I know there are tons of YouTube videos out there of the insane things people have done in this game with all kinds of different tools.
Yeah.
But to me, just I didn't have the great control over the Magnesis, just like you were kind of alluding to as well.
Well, one of the problems was the depth of it. Like, you couldn't really see how far it was. Like, so
that's
like, you
true.
Know, you sit there, you're swinging around. Okay, am I barely missing the Bokoblins? Or am I short by 10 feet? Or am I long by 10 feet? Like, you really just couldn't tell. And that's what I think made it so hard. Now, one thing I did do was I did like using the Magnesis to drop like objects like that on top of enemies' heads.
Yes.
I don't know, just with them, like, if they don't see you, I didn't really use stealth ability, so I probably
no.
had to get lucky when that situation happened. But just if they weren't paying attention, just kind of like holding up over them and then dropping on their heads, that was a lot of fun, I thought.
It's funny you mentioned the stealth ability. When a few parts ago, you know, I talked about how I don't use it a lot throughout the game. And in the last two or three parts, you've seen me use it like quite a bit attacking these Bokoblin camps. I get over that really quick.
Well, yeah, so
I'm like you. I just want to rush in sometimes, you know, and balls to the wall, take the guys out. So, but, you know, it's funny we talked about it, and yet here I am in these last couple parts actually trying to use stealth.
Well, the other thing is, like, you don't have a lot of hearts right now. Like, later on in the game, you can just run into a Bokoblin camp and go crazy because you simply have more life. Whereas now, like, you know, a couple hits can kind of, like, kill you, so
really
you'll be more cautious up front. It's the same with every Zelda game, so if you're going to use stealth, it is smart to use it up front. Man, that horse right there, That horse, after he shot that vocal blend, literally ran right up to you.
I'll tell you what, it made it really easy on me when the vocal blend was just rushing straight at me on the horse. It made me easy to line up the bow and shoot him. So I wasn't going to complain too much. And we've talked a little bit, like, this is one of the few times in the game you'll actually see me riding on the horses. It was still early on in the game. I wanted to try it out, see if I liked it. I really kind of didn't. So you won't see it a lot for me in the rest of the game, but I had to try it out early on. And just to me, there's something about running around and exploring on foot in this game world. I feel like if I play the game again, which God knows I'm going to.
Yeah, definitely.
But when I play the game again, I'll ride around a lot more on horseback just because I have a better idea of the world and kind of where things are. But being the first time playing through it, for the most part, I wanted to do it on foot to really take in everything the game had to offer.
Now, one nice thing with the horses is you can actually, if you're walking on a path, they'll actually go straight, and you can just look in whatever directions you want to and just, like, take in the views. First of all, that horse's name better been Freckles if you actually took that and went to the stable.
I don't think I did.
But, like, I did the same thing. Like, I didn't really ride horses a lot. Now, one thing I'm actually not sure about, and if you actually know this, please leave in the comments. I was not sure if the Sheikah sensor would work if you're actually on top of that horse or not.
Ooh, that's a good question. For some reason,
I was thinking, like, when I was on a horse, those never beeped. And so I was kind of like, well, this sensor must not work when you're on a horse. So that's why I found myself not using it that much. But kind of same way to you. Like, I kind of do like to just walk around. You're going to miss a lot of stuff on a horse because you're just going to ride right past it.
Agreed.
And then you also had the ability to warp places. So you really didn't need the horse to get to areas faster.
Now, the more points you unlock, like you said, whether it's shrines or towers, it really does. Like, it, anytime you get that fast travel, it makes getting around the world in any Zelda game so much easier. I try not to rely on it too much, but, you know, later on, obviously, you'll see me fast traveling all around the place. But early on in the game, like, once you unlock those places, it does really eliminate the need to ride run long distances on horses. So I'm totally with you. Like, the necessity just really wasn't there for me the further into the game we got.
I mean, it's more of like, I guess, maybe you just want to travel like a short distance. But once again, you could do that with the fast travel. So,
yep.
I mean, I roamed a couple times early on, kind of like you did, just to kind of get that experience from it. But,
yeah,
you know, I guess we're just like being a dead horse, huh? like, it really was something like, you know, for both of us that we just really didn't care for that much. And just, yep. I felt like we could just miss too much, so...
Now, there is something I did care for. You saw when I think it was when I jumped off that the platform a little while ago.
Yeah.
The ability to, like, draw your bow while you're in midair with the paraglider.
That's where I should have went. Honestly, like, I didn't have a point, so I just kept on beating the horse.
Hey, I was beating the horse there while I was riding it, so there you go.
Yeah.
But, yeah, just the ability to slow down time when you pull out your bow from the paraglider, I thought it was really awesome. It doesn't make a lot of sense, physics speaking. It's Zelda physics, though,
yeah.
Come on. But it's a really cool ability. It does drain your stamina super fast, though. That's one thing that you do have to be aware of, and then you could really go falling from a long distance if your stamina runs out. Well, you've still got your bow out. So it can be a tricky one, but it's so awesome to use to line up shots on enemies because it does slow down time.
One thing that I didn't understand is, like, why they just gave it to you at the very beginning of the game. Yeah, it was nice to have, but you would think that'd be, like, an ability that they would, like, you had to earn. Like, you had to do something, get it, like, halfway through the game. Like, you would have to earn that ability. Like, in Zelda games, things like that a lot are not given to us, so
they really
aren't. Right there, just to have it and, like, you know, yeah, they tell us how to use it, but... It was kind of in the background, like, you know, yeah, you did use it throughout the game, but there wasn't, like, a story to it at all, and that's just something you really don't see from Zelda and Nintendo too often.
Well, it's something, like, I compare it to, like, the hidden skills.
Hey, can we get to the Floret Sandbar, dang it, because I want to talk about this part more, because you're trying to talk past it. I know what you're doing.
I'm trying, and this is kind of what we talked about at the beginning of this part, just... To get to this shrine, if you step on these flowers, this girl will interrupt you, yell at you for stepping on all these flowers she's planted, and it makes you start over again. Now, the first time I played through this, I was playing, like, mobile and not recording. I was able to fly with the paraglider from the tree to the shrine without touching these flowers. So I tried that once or twice there, as you saw, and failed quite horribly. And walking the path here that's through these flowers did not go any better, as you'll see.
Well, that's how recording works. Like, when you do something behind the scenes, it always works out the way you want to.
Of course it does.
But when you go into recording, like, it just doesn't work out that way, and you always end up failing. I was just cracking up because I did this on the first try. I did not think it was hard at all. You just have to use, like, a little bit of patience, you know. Walk around a little slowly, and I think one of your problems was obviously jump off that tree trying to get to the shrine. But then you're
I know it works.
Yeah, like you're going by, you're trying to fight enemies and stuff, and so you're also hitting the flowers that way. But
I got screwed on that last one there, where I swung the sword and the flower touched it, and I was just like, "Come on, really?" But man, this girl Magda gets worked up about her flowers.
Yeah, she does. I kind of wish, like, you'll see it right here. Or you actually will not see it. Like, she kind of goes to kick our butt, basically. And I kind of wish they would have showed that part. Just, I don't know, I think it would have been, like, a really good visual. Just, like, show how serious she is. And just, it'd been a good addition.
It would have been, but since we don't see her kick our butt, this wraps up part 19 of Breath of the Wild.